Thank you for introduction. We are all aware that UCLA is the very birthplace of ARPANET. However, UCLA's activity is quite wide. For my personal memories, UCLA is a place of artificial intelligence. Here shows the evidence that was the one of the top conferences of artificial intelligence, ICHIKAI or IJIKAI, International Joint Conference on Artificial Intelligence, held in 1985. I made a presentation at ICHIKAI, which I will not explain it because it needs 15 minutes. That was my last activity in California at the time. I was a visiting scholar at Stanford University and the leadership of Professor John McCarthy, who coined the word artificial intelligence. And then I realized the real power of the ARPANET during my stay at Stanford University. And I returned from Los Angeles to Tokyo and back to my home institute, NTT Laboratories. NTT is a Japanese telephone company. Then I had a good news and bad news. Good news is my colleagues are eager to deploy IP network in Japan to facilitate joint international project. So then I simply follow the Stanford way, just purchase Cisco product as the first Cisco product user in Japan and ask SRI NIC to allocate global IP address, which is not connected in 1985. However, my friend Ken Murakami, using a modified version of iOS with the help from Cisco founder Len Bozak, who was a research associate at Stanford at the time. So then, other friends are quite eager to realize a multilingual realization of the internet and come up with the modified Mosaic browser with a server which is very hard to read, but it's 1993, just before the boom of the web, World Wide Web, and made by my friend Hitoaki Toshihiro and Susumu. They achieved their goal just before the boom of the World Wide Web. That's good. And then my friend Yasuki Saito negotiated with NSF and DOD to make the IP network official, the Ken Murakami modified iOS, realized, and the NTT and BBN. That's the very first IP packet between Japan and the US in summer 1988. So these are all good news, and the, we have a friend in Korea and China. We work all together to multilingual browsers and the servers, and that come to the international domain names right now. These are good news. Bad news was my dream in artificial intelligence, which I described in my paper at ICHIKAI at UCLA, was proved to be infeasible theoretically. Very sad story for me as a computer scientist. So then there are many supporters for IP network, and I have zero dream in artificial intelligence. I had to switch my primary research area from artificial intelligence to computer network. That's my personal story. So I learned a lesson. It's acceptable to give up one dream. Still, there should be something for us to contribute to human society. In my life, that was the internet. Thank you very much for inducting me to the Internet Hall of Fame. It's a greatest honor to me and my friends. Thank you very much.